You gotta hand it to Kamala Harris's supporters online and, of course, her rapid response team, because those people are not missing a beat. This week, during his rally in Pennsylvania, Donald Trump had what the Harris camp is now calling a, quote, senile moment when he repeatedly introduced Republican Senate candidate David McCormick as the future governor of Pennsylvania and mentioned multiple times how he's going to be a great governor in spite of the fact that obviously McCormick, the Senate candidate for Republicans in Pennsylvania, is not running to be the governor. Here is what Donald Trump said. He referred to him as the future governor, referred to him twice as Mr. Governor, and he said, "They're almost as tough as the man that's going to be your next governor, by the way. He's tough too. He's a great military hero." But he's not running for governor, as Donald Trump repeatedly said at least four times. And of course, I have to imagine the people in that crowd were a little bit confused. And they're like, "Well, I thought he was running for Senate. I don't know what to do now. Who do I vote for what? Because this dumbass doesn't even know what he's talking about." So the Twitter account called Kamala's Wins immediately put out the video with this caption. They said, "In a senile moment, Donald Trump says Dave McCormick is doing great in a race for governor of Pennsylvania. McCormick, of course, is running for the Senate. Retweet, so all Americans know Donald Trump is senile and losing his cognitive abilities." J.J. Abbott, who served as press secretary to former Pennsylvania Governor Tom Wolf, said this: "Last night, Trump couldn't remember Dave McCormick's name or what office he was running for. I guess at least he didn't call him that guy from Connecticut." And then, of course, Jennifer Bendry, senior politics reporter for HuffPo, said, quote, "Trump boasted Wednesday that he can speak for 2 hours without a mistake and then introduce Pennsylvania Senate candidate Dave McCormick at a rally as your next governor, and then did it again 15 minutes later." So yes, the irony is Trump up there saying, "Hey, I can talk for 2 hours without making a mistake. Now, here's your next governor." Like, literally after saying you don't make mistakes, you make a pretty big one. The reason this is important, of course, remember when President Biden messed up somebody's name recently? Obviously, kind of rough. When he called the president of Ukraine Vladimir Putin, right? That was in the headlines for days. Days! This one's already dead. Like, this issue of Donald Trump not knowing who he's speaking about, who he's speaking to, who is standing next to him on stage, didn't remember his name at first, and then repeatedly couldn't remember what office he was running for. Not a peep out of the damn media. Not a friggin' peep. And that's why Kamala's rapid response team is so damn good at this, because they know the media is not going to cover this. Donald Trump's cognitive failings have received a fraction of the media attention that Biden's have, even though that Trump has had more of them more frequently and for a longer period of time. Maybe we're all numb to it at this point. I don't know what it is, but the media is not talking about the fact that Donald Trump's brain has turned into a pile of goo. And I think that's a pretty big issue. I mean, they thought it was a big issue with Biden, but apparently when Trump does it, the media says, "Yawn, he does it every day, so clearly it's not." No, he does it every day, so it's more of a problem. And that's the problem with the media. I don't care if you have to do segments on it every single day. When he screws up, when he shows us that his brain is not working, that's a story. Every time. Not because you want the clicks and views, but because it's vital for the American public to understand if you vote for this guy, you're voting for Mr. Mashed Potato Brains. Well, folks, we have crossed that 1 million subscriber milestone, but rest assured, we are just getting started here at Ring of Fire. So if you're not already, please do subscribe to the channel and make sure to like, share, and comment on the videos.